go to our next presentation.
Interrupt your workday with important breaking news. This is your Qnet reporter, Barbara Soros. This just in. QualityNet Lucid now has many roles available for our CCSQ QualityNet population. This exciting enterprise Lucid suite consists of LucidSpark and LucidChart, two very effective virtual whiteboarding tools. Why, you ask, should you bother to get a role? Well, if you're like me and strive for excellence, then you'll want to submit a Lucid role request. LucidSpark will help you foster fully engaged participants at your meetings. And we all know, in this day and age of remote multitasking, how impossibly unengaged so many meeting goers can be. With LucidSpark, your participants can collaborate with easy enjoyment both before and during your meetings. And you'll find with Spark's visualization that your team and stakeholders gain alignment faster than ever. With LucidChart, you have a library full of templates to help you create charts, diagrams, and infographics, including flowcharts, org charts, timelines, and PI planning boards. Best of all, if you select the licensed user role, you can share your LucidSpark boards with Jira and sync in real time bi-directionally. Wonderful, don't you think? So, choose from three different types of roles. The first is an actual licensed role. Licensed Lucid users are able to create and manage LucidSpark boards and LucidChart diagrams. Be aware though, licensed roles are for board owners, scrum masters, release train engineers, product owners, and team managers only. But don't fret if that's not you. Go ahead and request the limited access role. The limited access role requires each user be registered with Lucid. Users can view Lucid boards shared with them through a shareable link with guest collaborator permissions from the host or owner. Only a maximum of 5 boards per year can be edited, and you cannot utilize the Jira integration. You'll also have access to view LucidChart diagrams with a guest link. You cannot edit those diagrams. So if it turns out you need a licensed role, then you can always make a new role request. Last, you can just sit back and be an anonymous user. Anonymous users don't need to make any role requests. You only need to reach out to a LucidSpark board owner to gain viewing access to the desired board. As an anonymous user, you can edit a maximum of 5 boards per year. Anonymous users, however, cannot utilize the Jira integration and do not have access to LucidChart. Why don't you take 2 minutes now and get started? Request your QualityNet Lucid role in HARP. Here are the steps. 1, go to harp.cms.gov and log into your HARP account, which will take you to your user profile. Step 2, select user roles. Step 3, request a role. Step 4, select the QualityNet Lucid program. Step 5, select your organization. And step 6, select the required Lucid role. That's it! You will be notified via email when your role has been approved. Once you get your role approved, log in at qnetlucid.cms.gov. If you want to improve your meetings, be more skilled with graphs, charts, and infographs, then the solution is clearly Lucid. See what I did there? Lucid, clear. Get it? Now, back to your regularly programmed work.
Well, what a coincidence, because we actually have a presentation from the Lucid software team now. So I'm going to hand it over to Matt and Mark to talk more about that.
Thank you, Julia. And that's going to be a tough act to follow with Barbasaurus. Mark, do you mind just sharing your screen, please?
Yeah. Just give me 1 second. There we go.
So hi, all. I'm Matt Murphy, the Customer Success Manager over here at Lucid. I, along with Mo Fitzgerald, represent the account team. Today, Mark Moomy, our solutions engineer, is going to go into the Lucid suite on how you can use LucidSpark with the Jira integration to support some of your agile planning efforts. We'll also make a quick plug before I hand it off to Mark. We will also be presenting at World Usability Day. Our theme will be visual collaboration in the Lucid suite. See the future, then build it together. We hope to see you all there. I'll hand it off to Mark.
Awesome. Thanks, Matt. Today I'm going to be doing a quick broad overview of Lucid and the products that we offer, just for those people who aren't familiar. Then we'll be hopping into LucidSpark and running through a quick scenario, you know, involving brainstorming and using our Jira integration. So for that quick overview, we have three main products, two of them, which we kind of consider our core suite that we'll be talking about most today. So Lucid Chart is our intelligent diagramming solution. So this is a place where you can go to make diagrams that explain complex processes, data flows, value stream mapping, process workflows, et cetera. Very powerful tool, great opportunities to integrate data there as well. And then LucidSpark, which is where we're going to be, you know, focusing on today, is our online whiteboard. It's a place where you and your team can gather around and, share ideas, vote on things, come to a consensus, throughout a project process, et cetera. And then LucidScale is more of a niche product, but it focuses on diagramming cloud infrastructure. We won't be talking about that today. So hopping over into LucidSpark. There's going to be a lot of tools at your disposal. One of the main tools that we always love to show off, of course, though, is our sharing options. When we're sharing, for you guys, it's going to be mostly done through shareable links. These links are very configurable. You can determine exactly what access the people clicking on these links can utilize. So whether that's shared ownership of edit and share all the way down to view only access, you get to determine that when building these links. As well, you also have the opportunity to generate what we call guest links. These guest links are a great option for bringing someone who doesn't have a Lucid account in. So no logins required for those guests, and they'll be able to participate in these boards, leave sticky notes, participate in voting sessions. Participate in anything that a licensed user has set up. These links also have additional layers of security on top of them. Passcodes, expiration dates, et cetera, can all be set. Once you've shared a board out with people, you can start the whole process by utilizing any of our templates for LucidSpark or LucidChart. They're broken down into different categories, so I strongly recommend you take a poke around here and see what there is, so you don't have to duplicate any work. You can use these as examples or jumping off points for you moving forward. Lots of great stuff here. And if you tweak any of them, you always can save them as personal templates, so you can leverage them later on. But hopping into the product itself, we're going to run through a scenario where we're brainstorming a fourth core to-do list. And some of these items are going to be going into Jira. So I'd invite, all my team members onto this board, and we'd start throwing sticky notes out there. Maybe we'd start a timer in conjunction so that we all stay aligned in terms of our time constraints. We can double click anywhere to add a sticky note onto the canvas, typing out our great ideas. And even starting to react to other people's ideas with emojis, showing our support, or even organizational tags if we want to, start to group these into different bins. These organizational tags, completely customizable. You can change them at any time. You can update them at any time to fit your exact needs. So whether that's priorities, teams affected, work estimates, so on and so forth, all can be created in these tags. Once we have a whole host of ideas, Lucid makes it very easy to sort through these ideas. I can quickly just highlight all the issues, all the sticky notes that I want to start to sort, and either choose to group them based on tag or color, or I even can throw them into something that we call dynamic matrix. These dynamic matrices are pretty cool because I can define my X and Y axis. So if I want to just see things sorted by those tags and say I don't need any rows, I can do that, have all these ideas sorted by those tags. And if there were ones that, you know, got missed in the tagging process, I can quickly and collaboratively apply those tags just by dragging and dropping sticky notes into their appropriate swim lane, basically. Once we have a whole bunch of ideas, maybe we want to go to the next step with these high priority ideas here. These high priority ideas, we're going to narrow it down to, you know, maybe the top three. So to do that, I'm going to start a voting session. I'm going to stop this timer real quick. These voting sessions, very easy to set up. You have private voting, voting on current selection, so just what I have selected. And I even can choose the votes per person. So I'm going to call this voting session top three. And Matt and Mo and I are going to vote on what we feel are the top three priorities. So when I started that voting session, Matt and Mo were prompted to join this, and they can quickly, you know, leave their votes on these different ideas just by hitting that plus icon. And when I see that, you know, the voting is completed, I can end that voting and see those results. So we see that Matt's really in favor of having an ice cream party. That's going to be one of our highest priority ideas. Going forward, there's a few directions that we can go with this. We always can convert this over into a kind of internal Lucid card. You can add descriptions, have more details around statuses, et cetera. These also work really well with our timeline tool. So you can start to build out a timeline of issues kind of internal to Lucid. But something that is really cool is the ability to sync these issues into Jira. It's a bi-directional integration. So I can right click on any Lucid card or sticky note and say, hey, I want to convert this over into a Jira issue. It's going to ask me for those fields required for issue creation. In our case, it's pretty simple. I always can view those other fields though and start to fill those out as well. But when I hit convert, that's going to start a link between Jira and LucidSpark that will, you know, bidirectionally manage this issue. So now it's a card. I can even get the ball rolling really quick by, you know, adding story point estimates, getting somebody assigned to it directly from LucidSpark. And those fields that I'm changing will sync directly back to Jira. If there are custom fields that for some one or the other reason we can't affect from either the card or this menu, we always can jump to Jira by clicking on the issue number, and that'll bring me directly to that issue so I can add those custom fields or link issues together. The other half of this integration is the ability to import issues from Jira. So I can even use advanced searches with JQL queries to narrow down to exactly what I want to see. But if I have a selection of issues that I want to bring in, I can import those as loose cards, and we can start to use these as visual elements in planning. That might look something like this, where we're trying to map out dependencies, do it very collaboratively with our team. Maybe we're throwing it onto a PI planning board so that, you know, we can start to brainstorm out dependencies, blockers, et cetera, teams affected. Another really useful feature though with these Jira cards is the ability to insert them into their own dynamic matrix. So I'm going to throw them in there. And now I can even start to change fields based on the X and Y axis that I have set up. So I'm just going to change one of these real quick just so we get another column. So if I wanted to, you know, move these not set cards around and get them assigned out to somebody, I could just drag and drop them into the correct spot in this matrix, and it'll update the fields accordingly. Lots of great capabilities when it comes to that, that Jira integration allows you to kind of streamline work and go straight from brainstorming to having those issues tracked within Jira itself. Another quick piece that we want to show off is what we call visual activities. I'm going to show this off in the form of a retro. Basically, these visual activities come in four different flavors. They come in a vertical axis, so basically ranking ideas on one criteria. double axis, so two criterias, matrix, or a categorization activity. We have a lot of different templates for these to kind of get the ball rolling. So you can just drag and drop one of these activities out and start to customize exactly what you want to see, you know, the text and everything. I even can customize exactly what items we're going to be voting on. So in this example, I have a mixture of sticky notes highlighting major events. I have some JIRA cards highlighting the major stories we worked on. And I'm going to, you know, save these changes and say, hey, this can be our quick retroactivity. I even can make it anonymous if need be. And when people jump in to participate, they're going to be in their own, They're going to be in their own experience and they're going to be able to give their feedback by, you know, very visually dragging and dropping items into, in this example, you know, what went poorly, what went well, what went okay, and be able to give their feedback without any leadership bias or manager bias, whatever you want to call it. When participants hit submit, their results are going to be saved, and then you're going to be able to view those results. So I can view each individual's response. I even can see an overview and set an agreement threshold. And I have another example of this one right here with a few more responses. So I can, once again, view those individual responses, or I can set an overview. And then if I want to see items that four or more of us agreed on, I can set that threshold. If I want to see where six or more of us agreed on it, I can see, you know, that there was only one story that six or more of us thought, hey, this went okay. So it's a great tool for getting feedback from teams. You also have the ability to, of course, export all this data to a CSV if you want to manage it that way. We try to be as flexible as possible with these visual activities and getting feedback from teams. Okay, that's what I want to show off today. There are a lot of features, not only in LucidSpark, but LucidChart that allow you to really visualize your work and gain alignment between teams. Of course, if you've got any questions, feel free to throw them into the chat. I'd also know that there has been a lot of work put into a Lucid Help Center. So you utilize that as well. But I'll give it back to Julia.
Okay, so at this point, did we have any additional questions for the Lucid software team? I saw that there were a couple already in the chat that they had gotten back to, but I didn't know if we had any additional ones as well. I don't see any others coming in. Okay. So as Mark said, there is the help Slack channel there. And then also you can create a ticket for any Lucid assistance. So feel free to reach out that way if needed. Thank you so much.